This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for a multiple linear regression with G-power. A general introduction to G-power is linked in the info cards and the video description. When we start G-power, we get this overview by default. We now need to select the multiple regression first. This can either be done via test family and statistical test, or via tests, correlation and regression, linear multiple regression, fixed model, R-squared deviation from zero. Now you have to select the type of power analysis. Since you have to calculate the minimum required sample size in advance, you have to select a priori. The first input parameter you have to specify is the effect size F square. Usually R square is known as the effect size for a multiple linear regression. You can easily transform R square to F square by dividing R square by 1 minus R square. The formula is in Cohen 92 a power primer on page 157. Conveniently, this also provides effect size thresholds if you have no idea what to expect. Those thresholds are also shown as a tooltip within G-power. If you have research field specific thresholds though, use those instead. However, if you have a preliminary study or comparative study where an R-square or F-square exists, then you should rather use that. Be aware though that R-square is inflated the more predictor a model has. So if for example you want to use 3 predictors and a study with the same dependent variable has 8 predictors, you should be cautious. The second input parameter is the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention, 1% is a bit more restrictive, a value above 5% should be avoided. The third input parameter is power. Power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. 95% power is typical, meaning you have a 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 0.95, this usually calls for a reasonable justification. The fourth and final input parameter is the number of predictors. This corresponds to the number of predictors you actually have hypotheses for. So if you have 6 predictors with hypotheses, you enter 6 here. If you have covariates, you want to change the statistical test to linear multiple regression fixed model R square increase. Here you will enter the number of tested predictors, those you have hypotheses for. So let's say 4 out of your 6 predictors are covariates. This makes 2 tested predictors and 6 total predictors. Finally, hit calculate to see the minimum number of observations needed to detect the presumed effect size with the predefined type 1 error probability, power, and number of predictors and/or covariates.